horizon wall of diamond, black-hearted boy. All empires rise and fall. All men eventually fall from grace. So what does it mean to fall from grace? The answer lies not in religion, not in tradition, not in how you feel about it, but in the word of truth. In fact, Paul tells us in no uncertain terms who the people are who have fallen from grace. He declares that you who are seeking to be justified by law, you have fallen from grace. For if you are trying to make yourselves right with God by keeping the law, you have been cut off from Christ. You have fallen away from God's grace. Who is it that has fallen from grace? Is it those who are living in sin, such as sex, drugs, and drinking, that we in the church so frequently condemn and point the finger at us those who have fallen? No, it is remarkably the opposite. Those who have fallen from grace are those who are seeking to be justified by the law. That's right. To fall from grace is to knowingly or unknowingly revert back to thinking that you can do something to maintain the right standing you already have with God through Jesus Christ. It is foolishness that all of us have fallen into at one time or another, and it is the greatest deception that the body of Christ has ever faced. If the grace of God is undeserved, unmerited, you earned favor with God, then how can you lose it? The answer is you can't. His grace was never something he rewarded you with because of your great performance. It was a gift that he lovingly bestowed upon us, and then asked for nothing in return other than our thanks. And yet the gift is much more than that. There is life and power in God's grace from one moment to the next as we rest in it. In fact, it is His grace that is instructing us to deny ungodliness and worldly desires, and to live sensibly, righteously and godly in the present age.